So we're here in Big Bay, South Africa. That's Big Bay behind me. That's the home of the Red Bull King of the Air. And we've got Ken Langeree, who spends his winters here in Cape Town. And Jesse Richman from Maui, who's also here for the King of the Air. And I flew over for a few days to hang out with the boys and kite in the in cold water and epic kite surfing conditions of Cape Town. Third year coming to Cape Town for the Red Bull King of the Air. I had never been to South Africa before that, but Kevin's been coming here for many years. And what's the main attraction? Why do you keep coming back to Cape Town, spending your winters here?
I just really love this place. You know, there's a good vibe. The people are very nice and friendly, and I like the African style. But most important of all, the wind conditions are just so good. You know, on average, we get like 5 or 6 days of the week. We get wind and waves, and I don't know, after the first time I got here, I think it really got me, and I just keep coming back.
You know what a lot of people find pretty interesting is, you know, obviously Jalou has followed in your footsteps, and she's become, you know, one of the best female kiters in the world. She clearly rips, especially in the waves, harder than probably 99% of the men in the world. What's really interesting is the relationship that you guys have as a brother and sister. You travel together, or at least spend a lot of time in the same place at the same time as each other. I mean, how is it, you know, having your sister be a fellow competitive kiteboarder and being so close?
Yeah, it's great having Jalou around, and I think we really motivate each other, and we pretty much ride 80% of our sessions are together, and I think it really pushes me, but it also pushes her, because she's just probably one of the most motivated kiters I know. I know I'm pretty motivated, but she's almost like next level motivated.
And she's always like the first person on the water in the morning.
Yeah, first person to go out and last person to come in, you know, and that's very motivating. And the other thing I love about this place is that there's a lot of friends that come over, and there's a lot of people I know here. It's almost like home away from home.
Okay, action.
Kevin's kind of favorite spot to come wave ride. Pump up and I'll see you on the water.
Thank you.
Mystic House. This is where the majority of the riders are staying, and it's kind of the center hub for the King of the Air this week. So they're actually going to do a safety meeting, a little CPR meeting for the riders. You know, the stuff guys are doing now is getting to the point where a bit of safety concern is good, teaching everybody a little bit about how to take care of themselves and each other in the water.
We are much safer now. And hopefully nothing is going to happen, but pretty likely something will happen. But that makes it exciting too, you know?
I'll see you at Big Bay in like an hour and a half for a little boosting session.
Go big.
Go big.
Go home.
I'll watch you go big.
Right here?
We're just going to go out here at Big Bay, and these guys are going to train a little freestyle. We've got Paul Serin, who's training for the PKRA. And he and Kev are gonna go mix it up, and I'm gonna go get in the way.
It looks windy, the waves are big, the sun is shining. Let's go boost.
Jump so high.
How the Naish team travels in comfort.
First class back here, baby.
Yeah. If I wake up, I believe in God.
Shop, shop.
You like my clean windows? Cleaned them specially for you.
It looks like a palm tree on the outside.
Almost went to Houtbaai. We were that close. We got a phone call that we had to do an interview.
Apparently it's an interview with the president and they needed us.
Yeah,
so.
Very important. So that's why I was dressed up all nicely.
Yeah.
I gonna went to the hairdresser specially for it, so.
Meet the officials.
Yeah, looking sharp.
Give them some advice. I mean, they asked for our counsel, so we'll do what we do.
Here with Jesse Richman, 2013 RedBull King of the Air champion, who injured himself last year during the event. Kevin went on to win, so that's all right. So right now we're 2 for 2, which isn't bad. What kind of gear are you, you know, looking at?
I'm riding the Torch again, just because the Torch handles the strong, gnarly conditions so well. And I've been riding bindings for the last six years now. And this year I switched back to riding straps most of the time, just because they're more versatile. You can do more with it. You have a lot more freedom, and it really doesn't limit you that much.
Well, I mean, the bindings are bindings. The foot strap system have come a long way in the last couple of years too, right?
Yep.
I mean, that has to play into being able to go back to straps confidently, because
yep.
the system itself provides so much more structure, so much more support, but you can get in and out of them when you want, right?
I mean, our Apex bindings this year feel more like almost like the ankle support that a binding would have, but they're a lot lighter and they're a lot freer. You can still do board offs, and it's a rigid strap that I can like push off against really hard and still have probably more padding too than the bindings.
Ice cream?
You scream?
Everybody scream?
For ice cream.
Oh, you want to put it in the car?
Yeah. So we've been training super hard, getting ready for contests, getting ready for the year, really just trying to be as fit as possible. And it's hard, it ain't easy being an extreme athlete, but.
Large. What's the plan?
The plan is to find some waves.
Woohoo!
Not much wind lately.
Luckily, we got some stand-up boards.
My farms smell like Red Bull.
Bending around the reef.
Whoa. Like the McDonald's for the sharks.
Yeah.
Now I appreciate the times I get to, cause there ain't too many times I get to, and do what, and just, yeah, so when I appreciate the times I get to, cause there ain't too many times I get to, and do what, and just, yeah. Now Jeter said that I'm a superhuman, and they be saying I'm a super dad. How do you do it? How do I do it? Well, if you listen to my music, never claim that I'm the best, could always use improvement, right? Behind my desk all day, I come home to my daughter, ain't no rest, just playing. When my baby's in the first dream, I'm on my first verse. You go to bed, I'm sitting down writing my first words. And when you get up, the chances are I've been up. Already did my push-ups, dips, and even chin-ups. They ask me for a favor, I'm like, yes, I will. I got a problem.
So that pretty much wraps up our Red Bull King of the Air 2015 preview. I've been here for 5 days now. Had some really fun riding with Jesse and Kevin. Even got a session in with Paul Serin, which was nice. The conditions kind of waned off the last couple of days, so unfortunately I'm not going to get to watch the contest this year. But Kevin and Jesse stay on. I wish them luck. This is a great place to ride. If you've never been to Cape Town before, you should definitely put it on your calendar. Come visit this place. It's a fantastic kite spot with a really good vibe, a lot of options, and at least for the last few days, usually pretty consistent kiteboarding conditions. So I wish the boys luck. See you next time. Bye. And take it easy, dawg. Take it easy, dawg. I hear this shit all the time, but I'm keeping calm. I guess they're throwing up by the constant.
Cut it in?
Yeah.
Nice.
Missing your truck?
Yeah, miss my truck.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Reporting live from Dare to Stain, Cape Town, South Africa. The waves are pumping. Woo-hoo.
Look at that.
Huh?
It's probably the healthiest thing I've ever seen Robby drink or eat.
This one's gonna come out of Robby's nose when he hits the lake.
This is a foot strap. More people should learn to use them, they're awesome.